How's it going? I am so happy to be back after a long stay away. It was more like a vacation, but it was more like a mind reset for the new year. I just wanted to make sure that I am in the right mind and I am relaxed and focused on what I want to bring you guys for this year. I'm doing some videos today. I'm sitting my little butt down and I am doing videos today. Ignore the lashes. The lashes came on a separate video that I have up here, or probably will be up here very shortly. I'll put a link to it. Oh, my nose is itching. I'll put a link to it down below here so you can see that fiasco. But they're on now, they're staying on, and I'm not ripping them off. So as I'm continuing my videos, if I look a little glammed up, that's the reason, okay? In today's video, I wanted to approach overnight masks, so overnight creams and masks that you can use during the day, because I figured this out that during the day I am home and I'm not doing much, and I have my hair up in a ponytail and I've just got my flannels on or whatever. I'm doing, work back there. As you can see, we've literally taken away our formal dining room has now become like a second office. This is my primary office here, inundated with computers, as you can see. My son does some work back there on his photography and on his college classes, and then I'm way back there doing my daily day-to-day work. And then I've got my camera set up here for my, for my YouTube and my videos and all the other, personal stuff that I do. So, be that as it may, we are literally living at home, staying at home, doing everything at home. And why wait for nighttime to come to use your overnight masks or overnight creams when it's the daytime? I don't go out. I'm not really getting bombarded with a lot of sun rays or anything like that. I do walk the dogs maybe for 5 minutes during the day, and honestly, with the way things are right now and how cloudy and wintry it is out there, I'm not getting much rays. But I do use some sunscreen, during the day and blah, blah, blah. But there are times where I really like to put on a good masking cream during the day as I'm doing work at home. No one's seeing me. It doesn't really look like anything. It's just cream. It's just like cream, like day cream you would have. So why not, right? So I've got a couple of creams I'm going to show you. Some of them are the day, are the night masking creams. Some of them are just my go-tos right now for my day creams. And I wanted to mention some of the creams in my routine, my facial creams in my routine. Again, full disclosure, none of this was sent to me. None of this was gifted to me. I really don't, believe in doing stuff like that. I'm staying away as much as I can unless something is amazing and I've wanted to try it anyway and someone wants to gift it to me. That's quite all right and I will do an honest review, but I'm not begging for freebies or anything like that. I look at other YouTubers and what they are trying as far as their facial and skincare is concerned. And if I'm intrigued enough, and I do believe in that YouTuber, that's the caveat. If I know that they are an honest reviewer about what they're using and they really say something beneficial about a certain skincare program or line, then I will go out and try it and buy it on my own and try it for a little while. And then I'll get back to you guys and tell you how it has been on my mature skin. Full disclosure, this is it. I'm in my high 50s, knocking on the 60 door, knocking on the 60 door. And and it is what it is. This is my skin. I do have makeup on today because I'm testing another makeup for another video that I'm doing. So this is why I kind of look strangely today. But yeah, for the most part, I don't really do a lot of makeup while I'm at home. I try to give my skin as much of a rest as I can possibly get it to rest, because I think this is a wonderful time. If there's one positive that can come out of this whole mess, of staying at home and being at home and the virus and all of that other stuff is that our home skincare routine has really gone up, as far as I'm concerned, up a good notch. We are home. We have time. I can put a sheet mask on. I can put some cream on. I can indulge myself during the day where I was not able to do that while sitting in an office. Can you imagine sitting in an office and you pull out your sheet mask and put it on you while you're typing away? No, that's not going to happen, right? So the same goes for these creams. Some of these heavier creams that you want to try out, that put some shine on your face, or even oils. You know, there's so many wonderful oils that you can put on your face during the day that are beneficial while you're sitting there typing away and doing your thing. You know, hair up in a bun, glasses on, t-shirt and flannels on, and you just have nowhere to go or nothing to do except indulge your skin. And that's what we're all about here. You know, we're about skincare and health and beauty and everything else, as you guys know, if you have subscribed to me. If not, you really should, because you're missing out on a lot of good stuff. I'm telling you, don't listen to me, listen to everybody else. You're missing a lot of stuff, okay? All right, enough blabbing, Maria. Let's get to what I use. All right, C lavender chamomile. I bought this at Ulta. It's called Vitamin C Beauty, and it's a sleep mask. You've seen me use this and talk about this in a number of my videos, and I just have to throw this one in here because, again, this it smells lovely, and it's got this really pretty lavender kind of looking color to it. And what I like about it is it's almost got that yogurty texture to it. I love it. It's cooling. It goes on your skin beautifully. And this plays very well for daytime use as well. I can put it on and have it on for a number of hours as I'm working, as I'm doing my thing. Let's say I put it on around 10 a.m. or 9 a.m. And then after lunch, I'll just wash my face and wash it off. And it's had a chance to be on my face for about 4 or 5 hours at that point, and your face is just absolutely gorgeous, just soft and wonderful and hydrated and plumped up. And you know, I don't wait for it now at night to put it on there to sleep the entire night. I figure if I get about a 4 or 5 hour block where this is on my skin, I am going for it. This is absolutely wonderful. So I'll put that on side. One of my daytime moisturizers that I have really, really, really liked, and I'm so surprised that I like it, because honestly, to me, e.l.f. and skincare, they're kind of middle of the road. I'm not like gaga about it. I don't use any of their cleansers and this and that and the other thing. But I found this e.l.f. Holy Hydration face cream. That's how that looks like. And I love it. Love it. There you go. I don't know if you see it. It's just a white cream, and it is a very smooth, very, very hydrating cream. Put a little on my hand there. It just goes right in. There's a ton of water on there, a ton of whatever hydration is. It's just marvelous. My skin just sucks it up like a cactus. I'm telling you, it's wonderful. And you know, you can put your makeup on afterwards. There's nothing really oily about it or anything. There's just wonderful hydration without the oiliness, and it's gone. There, it's gone. It's in there. It's in there. I absolutely love it. I can't live without this one, and that's very, very high marks for me to say that, because I don't usually, like I said, tout things that are just that marvelous. But I really, really like that one. All right, my Honest Hydrogel Cream Beauty. That's been a really good tried and true. I'm impressed with this one. I've had this for a number of months now, and almost gone. It's a really good go-to. It's on my nightstand for a lot of nights, so I really like this one for when I put on either Differin or my Retin-A at night, and then I wait it out, make sure my Retin-A is absorbed. And this is really one of the ones that I go to at night. But again, I can use this during the day. It is fabulous. It goes right into your skin. There's nothing wrong with using this, during the day. It works very, very well. But I'm just letting you know how I use these things and how I use these products. Now, this L'Oreal Revitalift Overnight Mask, I didn't even realize, there it is, see if you can see it. I didn't even realize that this is a mask. It's touted as a mask. It's not touted as a night cream, but apparently it is a night cream, okay? So these are one of the ones, and it's a slightly yellowy look to it, if you can see. It's not as white, and it is kind of like a watery, I can definitely see that it's migrating, it's going. I could put a little on my, there you go, if you see that. There it is. It's a lovely texture. It really is. I'll put it on top of that one. It just goes in again. It's a little bit more of a heavier cream because it's more of a masking cream. So you have to realize that when you're masking, there's that layer that has to stay on there overnight, and it's got to get into your skin and lay there really nice as a barrier overnight. But it's a very soft texture. It's just absolutely wonderful. It has a nice scent to it. If you're not about scents, then that's not for you. But it does have a really nice, like a floral scent to it. It's not gonna keep you awake at night or anything, but it's got a really nice scent to it. Again, you can put this on during the day, even though it says night mask. Put it on, let it be on your face for 2, 3 hours, however long you have indoors. You can go out with it. I mean, it's completely gone. If you need to go out and do some shopping and come back and then rinse your face off, that's fine. You can have it on most of the day. None of these rules are made to be broken. There's no really set, oh, do it this way and not the other way, or it's going to be useless kind of thing. These are all meant to be active ingredients that are working on your skin for a prolonged period of time. And if you have the time to devote at home, or if you're like I said, shopping, just put your hair up and go out, shop, do your thing. No one's going to laugh at you because I don't want to say a real mask, but it's not a mask that anyone's going to notice. It's not a bunch of white or green, how you have a green mask or a mud mask on. It's not like that. No one's going to be able to tell that you are wearing a mask of any sort, a facial mask, okay? All right, wrapping it up. I've got two more to show you guys, and then I'm out of here. This one is the Botanix Simply Calm. I'm going to show you the box that it comes in, and I got this at Walgreens. I think they're available at Walgreens. I have seen them at Target. Don't know if they're at Walmart. You might be able to check on these. These have the cannabis in them, cannabis sativa seed oil, and this is a overnight hydrating mask. There you go. You can see that. I like that this camera can focus pretty well. It's pretty good. Okay, so and this is another one you can just put on. Now, this is a heavier cream. This sucker is not going anywhere. There it is. And it's really nice. I'll try this on this other hand. This is really the texture of like a Nivea cream. If you guys use Nivea cream, it is a heavier cream. Can you tell? It just stays. It stays where you put it. And again, this is not a cream, it's a mask. I keep forgetting to say that, but it's a mask. This probably, if you don't rub it in and you just layer it on, people will be able to tell that you're wearing this. Maybe not from far away, but up close, you definitely, it's got a sheen to it. It's got a certain sheen to it. It smells very botanical. It just smells like grass. can say that, but not real grass. I'm not talking about, that kind of grass, but it has an herbal smell to it, let's just say. It does go on, it does go in pretty smooth, but there is some tackiness. I'm just saying this one is just a little more tacky. You probably don't want to put makeup or anything on top of this if you're using this. This is something you want to be, alone. All of these, honestly, you shouldn't be putting makeup on top of it because then it just kind of doesn't serve the purpose of it. There. It does hydrate and it does go in, but it is stickier. It is a tacky kind of feel to it. All right, and the last one that I have here, gosh, I'm trying to remember where I picked it up. Maybe Ulta or ow, I just had a cramp in my neck here. Or maybe Marshall's, I can't remember. It's called Soy Balm Water Gel and it is by SOOAE. I think it's a Korean brand. I'm not sure. Let me put on my little specs here and try to read this for you guys. Soy Balm Multifunctional Cream combines the benefits of a toner, serum, and moisturizer. The unique memory gel texture helps skin absorb hydration quickly and deeply, creating a lightweight veil of moisture for an improved feeling of skin elasticity. Okay, so again, during the day type of thing. This one I haven't really used it overnight, so I'm just letting you guys know. There it is, and it's almost jelly-like. I don't know if you see this, but it kind of like wiggles. It almost like wiggles, and I know you probably can't see this. Let me try to see if you could see that. It kind of wiggles, almost like a jello. So there's plenty of, and it feels kind of jelly-like. Like it doesn't, it almost bounces like jello. Honestly, if I put my finger in it feels like jello there. And then, you just, I don't want to really use that much or anything, but it just has a very nice watery, hydrating feel to it, very calming, very soothing. You could probably use this for after your retin-A treatment or your Differin treatment if you want to use it at night and put it on there. But during the day, during the night, whatever you want to use, it's fine. So that is it. I think I got through everyone. One, two, three, four, five, six. Yes. All out of here. Wonderful. Wonderful, guys. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give me a thumbs up if you can. If you've enjoyed it, let me know if you have used any of these. I'm sure a number of you have used the L'Oreal one. I'm sure of that. And then possibly the e.l.f. one. But let me know what you've used, how you like it, what your feelings are about any of this, and if we're staying home, if we're benefiting from being at home and doing what we do, let's try to make the best of our skincare. Let's try to push forward and, have the best skin possible at any age and any gender and whatever. It's just the way it is. When you make lemons, you given lemons, make lemonade. Is that how you say it? Yeah. I'm watching kids walk by my driveway. It's so fun. A lot of people are enjoying some outdoor time now this weekend and walking dogs and everything. And I'm about to walk this one here. He's in the crate and he's settled down now. He's actually asleep, but I'm about to take him out. That's Biscuit. He's 16 years old, so he does need his little potty time, so I love you guys very much. Thank you again for sticking by and being with me this afternoon. I'm just loving that I'm bringing all this information to you guys. I'm trying to put some videos together today to have and getting back to the swing of things. Okay, love you, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.